Hi coaches, welcome back to the MOOC 1 of the iCoach e-learning program, Developing Effective Environments for Children in Sport. My name is Chris van der Hagen and I will be your guide for chapter 2. What is a coaching philosophy and why it is important to be clear about yours? Okay, cast your mind back to your high school years. Can you remember the names of any philosophers? Probably Plato, Socrates or Descartes come to mind. Do you know what they all had in common? Well, they all spent their whole life asking some fundamental questions like, who am I? What is good? Or what is the purpose of life? Why were they asking those questions? Well, in short, because the answer to those questions guides the way we organize our societies, how we live our lives, and more importantly, condition our day-to-day behaviors. We all ask these questions all the time. The only difference between Plato and us is that we don't write massive books about it. Well, kind of. We all philosophize, even if we don't realize it, write it down or talk about it. The answers we give to those types of questions become our personal philosophy, or the way we understand the world to be and how we want to live our life. You may be wondering, what's all this got to do with coaching? Well, it's generally accepted that personal philosophies drive our everyday behavior. As a coach, even if you have not stopped to think about it, you will also have a philosophy of what coaching is about and how it should be done. And this philosophy will certainly be having an impact on how you coach. For this reason, it's important that we take time to reflect on what our philosophy may be. What values and beliefs inform it? Are they appropriate for the context in which we coach? If we don't ask these questions, there is a big risk that things may not go as well as they could or should. Remember, we coach children, so we have to make sure everything is as good as it could be. By the end of this chapter, you will be able to 1. Explain what a coaching philosophy is. 2. Understand the role of ethics in sport. 3. Articulate and further develop your coaching philosophy. And 4. Reflect on the application of your philosophy to your day-to-day coaching. Okay, let's do this and see you in the next video.